Hey guys, Welsknight here, and welcome back to another episode of DesignTech. And in today's episode, we're going to be doing some building, and we're actually going to be playing around with a new mod that we haven't touched yet. And that mod is called Simply Paths. So basically, when 1.9 came out, there were path blocks added to the game, which is pretty awesome. However, this mod pack is not in 1.9. This mod pack is in 1.7.10. So, those path blocks are not in this mod pack. However, they kind of are, because we also have Et Futurum, which adds pretty much all the 1.9 and later version stuff into this version of Minecraft. But, essentially, what we're going to do is we're going to create a path that goes from the factory back to our starter base. And there's a mod in this mod pack called Simply Paths, which adds a whole bunch of additional path blocks to the game, which is pretty cool. The other really nice thing about them is you actually get a bit of a speed bonus when you are using them, and that is why we're using the paths from Simply Paths instead of some other option. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go ahead and get kind of an area figured out here for where the path is going to go. I'm going to bring it all the way back to the starter base, which is roughly 400 blocks or so, and I'll come back to you in just a sec. All right, guys, I am back, and I have the path all laid out, and it goes all the way from here back to the starter house. Now we need to put in all the blocks, and that is going to take a little bit of time. But we're just laying down regular old, plain old stone brick right now. And I know what you're thinking. You're thinking, well, that doesn't sound very interesting, but give it, have faith. Have faith. Don't worry, this will be awesome once it is all said and done. But the first thing we need to do is come through and actually get all of this stuff in place. Now, I need to kind of sort out this little section right here, because I want this to... let's grab some stone brick slabs. I want this path right here. Yeah, that'll kind of come up there. And then this can kind of come around here. Maybe we make that one stone brick as well, like so. This will basically all be stone brick, and then that will be stone brick. Yeah, that'll work, right? Yes, good. Okay, so what we're doing is we're basically laying down the groundwork, and what's going to happen, and kind of the way that I build in general, I'm going to lay down essentially a foundation of stone brick, right? And then after that, I'm going to come back and put in these path blocks. I'll come back and add some texture variation and stuff like that. That's just kind of the way that I personally build things like this. I find it a little easier than, I find it easier to do it this way than, for example, doing all the different blocks at once and all the texture variation and stuff like that at once. I like it. I like doing it this way. This is my way of doing it. You don't have to do it this way. You can do it however you want. This is the way that I do it. So that looks good. And then here we'll put those down. So there's our road, okay. And I've got a lot of stone brick, as you can say. Now, this actually gives us the opportunity to have a little bit of a chat, which is good, because I want to talk a little bit about design tech. We've been doing a lot of techie stuff lately, which isn't bad. That's not a bad thing. But we haven't really been doing a whole lot of building, and building is one of the big things that I want to be doing a lot of in this series. And we kind of haven't been doing that, so I'm going to try over the next few episodes. There's still some techie things I want to do, but I want to try and have a little bit more of a balance, I guess you would say, of tech and building. I want to do, more of more building. I don't want to say less tech. I don't want to just like forget that there's tech in the pack because, you know, it's design tech. Like, there needs to be tech. But at the same time, I also don't want to do just tech or just buildings. So something I need to kind of play around with. Okay, so that's good there. Now we're going to need stairs for here, I think. And I made a bunch of those as well. So let's just go starting here, I suppose. And let's actually turn that guy. There we go. And we'll do that. Yeah, that'll work. Okay, anyway. So, as I was saying, I don't want to forget that there is tech in the pack. I still want to do a lot of tech. I still want to do a lot of, like, automation and stuff like that. We've been getting into some mods and things like that that I've never played around with before, or at least not in the level that we're playing around. Like, all the stuff we did last episode with automating applied energistics, I've never done that before, ever. And it was a lot of fun, and it was a blast, and so many ideas are kind of popping up as a result of that. So, yeah, tech is not going away. But at the same time, I do think I need to do a better job of balancing the building aspect of this series as well, because this series is not just about tech. So that's kind of something that I need to work a little bit harder at, I guess. Another thing I should probably mention before I forget, there was a world download in episode 25, and it's been in the description of all the videos since then as well. So just in case you didn't notice, world download has been posted, episode 25, and it's all good. Now, as far as future projects go, there's definitely some stuff that I want to get into. Like, for example, Mechanism version 9 recently came out, and I definitely updated that as soon as I found out. So I do want to play around with the new Mechanism. I haven't played around extensively with the old Mechanism. So I think that's going to be a lot of fun. Let's maybe do that. There we go. That's a little better. And then stone bricks like so. Does that seem maybe here? Dirt. Yeah, that seems about right. Okay, cool. Anyway, so definitely want to play around with the new Mechanism, and probably relatively soon. That's kind of what I'm planning on doing in the next episode, I think. Even though I'm not super knowledgeable about Mechanism in general, so it should be interesting to kind of get in there and play around with it and see what we can do, see what kind of capabilities we can, what kind of capabilities the mod has, and some of the things that we can use it to, you know, maybe automate some things or open up some things. And there's a lot of really cool stuff in Mechanism. I know that much. I know that there's a lot of really cool stuff in Mechanism. I've just never really used any of it, if that makes any sense. Definitely on my to-do list. Also want to get into a few of the other mods. We've got Extra Cells 2 in here, which is from is basically an add-on for Applied Energistics that will allow you to do liquid storage as well, and gas storage for that matter, but liquid is the one that I'm more interested in because I want to get into automating. I kind of want to automate all the things, I'm not going to lie. Like, that just sounds a lot of fun. So I'm planning to kind of automate all the things, and we'll see. I hear a zombie. Hi, go away. That's on my to-do list. Also want to kind of do more with immersive engineering. We haven't really done a whole lot with it. We kind of played around with it a little tiny bit at like the very beginning for like the water wheel. But that was pretty much all we've done with it. And there's a lot more to that mod than just the water wheel. So that's also on my to-do list. Let's see. So we'll put this here. This needs to be a bridge right here of some sort. I don't know yet what we're going to do for it. For now, I'm just going to put the stone brick across like so. Here, there. Yeah, there we go. And we'll just kind of keep getting this put in. So let me finish getting all of these stone bricks in place, and then I'll come back to you in a sec. All right, guys, I am back. So I've got all the stone bricks in place, and now what I want to do is I want to come back and I want to kind of detail this a little bit more. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to grab a few other materials. We'll grab some cobble. Actually, let's not grab that much at a time. Let's grab... Let's grab about that much. I think that should be good. We'll put this here, and then I think I've also got... Yeah, we got some regular stone as well. So what we'll do is... Stone... like so. We're just going to come through this whole path... And I'm just going to kind of knock out random blocks here and there. And we're going to replace them with other textures. So we'll just do this little first part here together, and then I'll do the rest of the path. So you've probably seen me do things like this before. We're just going to put in some gravel over here into these holes. Like this. And then maybe we'll come back and we'll add a little bit of maybe some cobblestone, like over along here. Maybe a little bit more of that. Maybe here, 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 and here. That seems pretty good. So we'll just come back and... cobblestone parts of the path. So basically the primary block, the primary block for the path is the stone brick, but then we're just adding some texture variation to it with these other blocks. Because otherwise, just a plain old regular stone brick path is really kind of boring. It's not fun. It's not exciting at all. It's very, very boring. And we don't want that. We want a little bit more interest in our path. So we're gonna mix in some other materials, some more cobblestone and stuff like that. And then I'm thinking we're probably gonna mix in a little bit of smooth stone as well. So essentially our four materials that we're using are cobble, regular stone brick, gravel, and then just regular old smooth stone. And that should create a relatively good-looking path, I think. Yeah, that's pretty good. That's pretty good. I want to mix a little bit more of that smooth stone in kind of over here. And it's hard to teach randomize. It's hard to teach how to randomize stuff. Usually what I do is I just kind of move my mouse around like this and... click at random times, and then I just kind of look and see how spread apart some of the holes and things like that are, and, kind of go back and tweak it as needed. But here we have a relatively nice little road. I think it looks pretty good. So now I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to do that to the rest of this path, which is going to take a little while, and then I'll come back to you. All right, guys, I am back, and the path is fully in place. We've got the little texture variation going all the way along the whole thing. So now, the next step is actually to turn it into paths. So what we're going to do, we're going to take a shovel, a vanilla shovel, and a vanilla pick, and we're going to just right-click like this, and you'll see that recesses the blocks a little bit. Which is pretty cool, and that just kind of lays it down and does what we need it to do. Now, you can't do it on slabs, unfortunately, but you can do it on just about everything else. And you also get a little bit of a shadow here as well, which is pretty cool. So it works just like the path blocks in 1.9, except you can do it on a lot more on a much larger variety of blocks than just grass blocks. Because in 1.9, you use the shovel on grass blocks, and that's how you get the path block, and that's the only one that there is. There are no others. Whereas here, you can do stone brick, you can do gravel, you can do cobblestone, you can do all sorts of different stuff. And that is why I was using this texture mix, even though it's a mod pack, and there are other different textures and stuff available. The thing is, you get a little bit of a speed boost here. So, you know, here's our normal running speed, and we do have armor. We've got these leggings that make us run a little faster, which is good. But on the path, you run even faster than that. And you get up, and if you're jumping, you get a pretty crazy speed. So it'll just help us get back and forth a little bit faster. But now I need to go back along this entire path and do this. So let me get that done. All right, guys, I am back and the path is done. The path is all done. The only thing that we still need to do is we need to sort out the bridge over here and figure out what we're going to make this thing look like, because this crosses a little bit of a ravine right here. So I want to go ahead and do some sort of a bridge design. Don't really know what yet. We can put this stuff away because we're not going to need it anymore. But I think what I want to do is I want to clear the ravine back a little bit. Let's just go like this. There we go. And I think I'm going to clear this all the way down, to like the floor level of the ravine. There we go. Let's grab our magnet so that we can do this properly. There we go. Okay. So that's there. This needs to go as well because it looks a little out of place. There we go. Got it. Okay. Now, here's the bridge. And the bridge, I want to do something for sure. Let's grab our angel wings. There we go. Okay. And do we want to peel? I think I want to peel this back a little bit right here as well. Just so the bridge has a bit more space. That'll make it a 5 over here. Ooh, actually, I want that to be even. So I think we peel it back here as well. Okay. And let's just... Ooh, hello, iron. Didn't even realize that was there. Okay. So this should be good. This should do the trick. Let's clear. Okay, good. Good, good, good. Is that good enough? Almost. This needs to be back as well. Okay. That's better. Now, let's get rid of these dark oak logs that I put down here just to kind of mark stuff out more than anything else. And what we're gonna do, I think, is maybe we'll use the dark oak like this, right, going kind of into the hill right here. And I need a little bit more dark oak, don't I? There we go. And we'll maybe build this up a little bit. And then right here, we'll build that up a little bit as well. So that's kind of the base line of our bridge. Now, under here, we need to do some stuff to kind of make this look a little bit better, too. So here's what I'm thinking. I think we're going to go and grab ourselves some carpenter's slopes. Let's put them here. And I think we'll start them about here. And then we'll go... Oh. That's going to be really hard to place, isn't it? Yep. Although you can stand... You can actually stand inside carpenter slopes as you're placing them, which is really useful. So we'll do that. That. And that. And then same deal here. So we'll have basically like a little archway that kind of comes up from underneath the bridge and essentially supports it. That's the plan, at least. Here, here, there, and there. Okay, awesome. Now, if I apply this, it's gonna look really weird. So we're gonna have to do some other texture here of some sort, and I'm kind of thinking maybe we go cobble? No, I don't think so. I think it needs to be some sort of wood texture. Maybe we just take the dark oak and turn it into planks. That doesn't look bad. That doesn't look bad at all. I think we'll go with that. So we've got our supports kind of sticking up there. And then we need something underneath this bridge as well. So let's see what we've got for slab options. Maybe spruce would be good right here. Can I get in there? There we go. Maybe like that? That's not horrible. I do think that it would look a little bit better if we cleared that out and put another row of dark oak right here. Like that. Then again, maybe not. No, I don't like that, actually. I was just kidding. Just kidding. Okay, so actually, you know what we really should do? I know what we're gonna do. We'll use micro blocks. That will be the way to go. So, let's see here. What we'll do is we'll go in here. I need I believe it's sticks, and then a diamond to make the saw. It's been a while since I've done the micro blocks, but if I remember correctly, it's like that, right? No, it's not. Is it like that? No? Okay, you know what? Let me just look it up. Sticks. Oh, I need 3 stone tool rods. Okay. I was close. There we go. So that gets us our saw. And let's just go ahead. Can I not split? It won't let me split dark oak. Okay. Let me split that. Let's just get a handful of those. And then some of those. And we'll just make them as thin as we can. And I think that'll be enough. And we'll just put them right here. Let's get that one back. There we go. And we'll put those on the bottom of the bridge. We just want to cover up that stone texture, which doesn't look very good. Yeah, that looks pretty good. Okay, so we're good there. Now, I also want some carpenter's barriers to go right here. Like that, and I think that looks good as well. And then we just need to figure out what texture we're going to use for that. And I think I want to use a lighter texture, like oak, for example. Just because I think it'll look a bit better. Yeah, I think that's pretty good for a simple little bridge. I think that works. Okay. Now, I don't know. Can I apply glowstone to those. I can. So let's just put a little glowstone around that bridge just to kind of light it up a little bit. And then I think it is good to go. So we've got our full path that goes all the way back to the factory. Let's just run around, do all sorts of things like that. And I think it is all in good order. So, guys, that is all that I have time for in this episode. If you enjoyed this video, don't forget to like, subscribe, and leave me a comment. I do appreciate it, and it really helps out my channel. You can also find me on Facebook, Twitter, and Twitch. There are links in the video description below, so check that out as well. Otherwise, guys, thanks for watching, and I'll definitely see you next time.